Alright, up next we need to go ahead and get the magical saber, which will allow us to turn certain blocks into platforms, which we will most definitely need going into the final area. If only for that. Times I play this game, that part is a little bit confusing, knowing which one to go down. Okay. Literally only used for here and going into the final area. That's really it. Other than that, it's mostly useless. Actually gonna go back to the dragon's castle. Even though it's crumbled and whatnot, we can still go back in and get a lot of gold as well as a legendary sword. Seem a lot stronger because I don't have all the equipment I want right now, so you might want to do this later, but at the same time I'd recommend it because the only other option really to get a lot of money is that spot in the pyramid. Damn, they're still not dead. See, we have the legendary sword now, but there's one more thing we can do here. Go back in, and you'll have a shit ton of gold to just sit back and collect. Again, you can also go back to this spot whenever and keep getting gold. I don't think I'm gonna do that for the sake of this playthrough, though. And there's some very expensive armor up here that I think I'm gonna go ahead and go for. One of the main reasons why you have to basically grind, especially on your first time through or on hard, to get some of these. I've already got the best sword in the game, so... as a matter of fact, I think I'm gonna go ahead and go with the legendary shield, which we can get in the same area that we went to go get the legendary sword, though this time we had to pay for it. We'll see if I have enough anyways, because I can't remember off the top of my head exactly what it costs. Okay, just enough to get it, which we're definitely gonna need. Along with one more key. This is, I never really used a lucky sword, by the way. I did get it on my initial playthrough of this when it first came out, and really the only thing it really seems to do is drop a little bit more gold, or sometimes you get more hearts, but once you become experienced with the game, that's really not an issue. So sometimes goodies in this little area here, that's gating off the final area of the game. Now here you just have to switch over to the magical saber, and I believe the one we're looking for is right in the middle. There is honestly nothing else besides that to go through and break. And here we are, the Sky Palace. That right there would be the transformation room. Heads up, but we're not gonna need it. That's the other really bad thing about Hawkman. Whenever you're flying in the air, you can't protect yourself. And here's a shortcut here as well. You can totally go through this little wall so long as you're mouse man. And here will be another heart piece too, which helps, even though we're really late into the game. Still do take quite a few hits, even with the legendary sword. That goes to show how strong they really are. Now there are golden ones, and those are really nasty. And those are more prominent in hard, though. One of these guys will be so kind as to drop me another potion just in case. That's the only reason why I'm really bothering with them. That same token, I might as well just go ahead and just try and get through this. It's not even worth fighting these ninjas for, honestly. If you can help it. Just too damn many of them, and they deal too much damage. So unless you really need a potion or something, I wouldn't advise bothering with them. I can't remember. Okay. Yeah, even if you use like a lightning bolt, it doesn't light the area up, so... Don't even bother trying that. Anywho, we're getting really close to the vampire dragon. Just a few more screams. I think we are well equipped to take on vampire dragons so that we can go back to being human again. Because being a bunch of different animals is no fun. Well, it has been fun, but... this guy honestly kind of reminds me a little bit of Astaroth from Ghosts and Goblins with the whole stomach having a face that shoots fireballs thing he has going on. But... unfortunately, getting to him is much easier than the Astaroth. I may have to do a gameplay of Ghouls and Ghosts at some point. Yeah. Yeah, now you could be Hawkman and try and do this, but I consider Lionman to be a little bit more powerful. But there you have it. That is Wonder Boy the Dragon's Trap. Great game. I highly recommend it if you like Metroidvanias or anything of that nature. And as you'll see here, I'm going to shut up soon, but you see all the different forms, and then you go back to being human and you go home for the night. But yeah. I definitely didn't go for everything. This is definitely not the kind of route you want to take if you've never played this kind of game before. Definitely go back, grind, get the extra armor and items. You'll definitely need it. I just wanted to see how quickly I could finish the game and if I could do it without death, so there's that. I didn't die once unless you count using blue potions as death, but whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, anything. And also, I do have a gaming-related Twitter over at RetroRev96. That is RetroRev96. Have a great day, you guys.